Hello, this is Dr. Peter Kosmaly with my part of life cycle strategy plan for vivens. The sixth chapter is on intellectual property strategy, and the first part is patent history for vivens. As you can see, the patents were given in the year 2006 and 2007 on abuse-resistant amphetamine compounds and on abuse-resistant lysine amphetamine compounds. And in the year 2010, in February, patents were given on abuse-resistant amphetamine products and abuse-resistant lysine amphetamine compounds. Patents were given 3 years, 2006, where Shire and New River Pharmaceuticals announced FDA approval of the first and only stimulant product under the name Vivens as a treatment, as a part of treatment of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. In the same year, in the 2007, Shire announced a filling of Vivens for the treatment of ADHD in adults, and in the year 2010, Shire was given a 5-year market exclusivity for Vivens. In the year 2013, in the United Kingdom, the drug Elvance received marketing authorization. Patent timeline in the United States and Europe begins with the year 2005, where Shire announced New River Pharmaceuticals filling of drug under the name NRP 104. In through years 2006 and 2007, Shire received FDA approval for Vivens. Through years 2008-2009, FDA approved Vivens as the first and only once daily product stimulant to treat attention deficit disorder in adults, and in year 2010. FDA approved Vivens for the treatment of attention deficit disorder in adolescents. In the year 2012, Vivens was approved in the United States for maintenance treatment in adults with ADHD. In 2011, in Europe, there was Phase 3 study successfully completed of use drug under the name Venvance in children and adolescents with attention deficit and attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. In the year 2012, there was the product Venvance lisdexamfetamine still accepted for review for the treatment of attention and deficit disorder. So in Europe the drug is sold under the name Venvance, in Brazil under the name Venvance, in Canada and in United States under the name Vivens. For the question of biomarkers influencing the product, there were some mentioned statistically significant, such as norepinephrine or thymetoxy for phenylethylglycol monoamine oxidase. And other examples are the dopamine transporter D81 genotype and methylphenidate response. And using functional magnetic resonance imaging, researchers have identified abnormalities in the brains of children with this disorder, and these may also serve as biomarkers. comparing to a normal control group, the children with ADHD showed abnormal functionality activity in several regions of the brain involved in the processing of visual attention information. Any litigation, we may mention the year 2009, where the investigation of sales and marketing of Adderall, Dayton and Vyvanse was made in Shire, and in the year 2011, Shire was notified that six abbreviated new drugs applications were submitted under the were seeking permissions to market generic versions of approved sample of Vyvanse. In the year 2012, Shire terminated its co-promotion agreement for Vyvanse with GSK in 2010. The last part of this chapter is on unique strategies that the company developed to protect our asset of the product, and these are clinical studies and trials on other uses of this drug on treating non-ADHD conditions or other treatment. For Vyvanse, we may find 71 studies worldwide at clinicaltrials.co service of the US National Institute of Health. And for example, in Czech Republic, the first of two records is on efficiency and safety study of drug under the name SPD489 in combination with an antidepressant and the treatment of adults with major depressive disorder. And the second study in the Czech Republic is on treatment in adults on with major depressive disorder. Other examples of pilot studies include treat of for example of cocaine dependence with lisdexamfetamine, and of course other attempts to differentiate ADHD or attention deficit disorder drugs in the market include comparison studies, head-to-head studies, for example with Concerta. Also attempts to differentiate drugs in the market include peer and spin doctoring activities to manage communication, for example communication to support the product against slander, for example on the question of generic Vyvanse. As you can see, viral marketing crisis intervention are very useful in web discussions in fora or within press releases and media communication. Also related exclusivities and related patents are part of unique strategies that the company develops to protect asset of this product. Thank you for your attention.